Hello student, so now we are starting our first topic from the unit first and chemistry paper second, that is chemical kinetics. So the chemical kinetics topic we have already studied in 12th standard. Okay, so as we have discussed chemical kinetics, so this topic is totally related with the kinetics of chemical reactions. Kinetics of chemical reaction. So again, here we see content which are included in this topic. Okay, so this is what I am giving you brief again. Already we have discussed in the introduction to the syllabus. But see here, we are going to see the rate of reaction. At what rate reaction is proceeding from a reactant to product, okay, or what is the speed of reaction for the conversion of reactant to the product, that comes in the rate of reaction. Okay, after that we'll see the rate constant. Okay, sorry, this is the term used in the rate equation. Okay, and this is very helpful for us to study any chemical reaction that we'll see in the detail while studying the reactions. After that, we are going to measure the rate of reaction, okay, or the reaction rates, at what rate reaction is proceeding in any chemical reaction, okay, that is also we are going to study here. After that, we'll see what is order of reaction and what is the molecularity of reaction. This is very important. Most of the time, students get confused between the order of reaction and the molecularity of the reaction. Okay, we'll clear it. And after that, we are going to see how we can find out the different order reactions. Okay, their derivations are there, integration equations are there, and few numericals are there. So remember here, if you want to make a command on this first order reaction, second order reaction, okay, or pseudo first order reaction, so we need to solve maximum examples. Okay, after that only we will come to know that what the actual concept is. In whole chemistry, the same way we have to prepare. Okay, example solving is the only solution to get the clear idea about that concept. Okay, so because it is very, very related with the day-to-day activities. Okay, so we are going to see here integrated rate equation of first order reaction. After that, we are going to see the integrated rate equation of second order reaction. Okay, for that concentration will be equal at the initial stage. Okay, and after that, whatever will things happen, that we are going to see in the product. Okay, then we'll see determination of order of reaction. What method we are going to use to determine order of reaction? First method is integration method. Integration method. After that, graphical method is there. Okay, after that, post-Waltz isolation method is there by which we can find out the order of reaction. And at the end, half-time method, okay, of which we are going to study examples also. Now see here, the goal of chemistry, that is a chemical kinetics, okay, to understand the macroscopic world by examining the molecular world. What is the goal of chemistry? To understand what macroscopic world by examining the molecular world. Okay, so in the nature, whatever things you are seeing around you, okay, whatever things you observe around you, there is either energy or the matter, either energy or the matter. Okay, and that matter is composed from the molecule. Okay, that is made from a molecule, and molecule is made from atom. Okay, atom comes together to form molecule. Molecule combined together to form a substance. Okay, and now see, if you are using, you know, edible oil is there, talcum powder is there, and other, you know, cosmetics are there, perfumes are there. All are made from the molecules. Okay, so this is what. Our motto is to study at the molecular level what things are happening, what things are possible to happen. Okay, if we treat that molecule under different pressure, different temperature with the different chemicals. In this topic, we are going to look at how those changes occurs, how those changes occurs with the time, with the time. Okay, so the first concept, we'll see a rate of reaction. Okay, so is a measure of how fast the reaction occur. The measure of how fast the reaction occurs. Okay, so rate is expressed per unit time. Okay, as like a speed of car, it changes. Okay. See, speed of car is a change in a distance per unit time. Okay, that is, we call it as a velocity. Okay, so by which we can find out the speed of car. In a similar way, for a reaction, rate of reaction. Okay, the rate of change in the concentration of a reactant or the product with the time. The rate of change of concentration. Reactant react हो रहा है यहाँ पे. अभी reactant react हो रहा है उसका conversion product में हो रहा है जो कि reaction चालू है flask में. है ना? तो वो concentration reactant का decrease होगा और product का increase होगा. Right? Because reactant is getting converted into the product. Okay? So if we consider the rate of reaction with respect to the reactant, in that case, there will be the negative sign. You know, see here. Rate of reaction is given by. Now, this is the concentration. Change in concentration of reactant with respect to time. Reactant ka concentration kam ho raha, iski wajah se there is a negative sign. And product's concentration is increasing with the time because the reactant is get converted in, converting into the product. Right? So its concentration is increasing. That's why there is a non-negative sign. Okay, so dc is the amount of reactant reacted in time dt, and dx is the amount of product formed in time dt. है ना? जो कि reactant का conversion product में हो रहा है या हो चुका है इतना, right? So we'll see now what is the rate constant. Okay, then it's a definition and unit. See now. The expression for the rate constant of a reaction is obtained by using law of mass action. Law of mass action. So according to law of mass action, the rate of a general reaction is given by, see, a number molecule, a moles of a, small a moles of capital A, small b moles of capital B. Here this is wrong, this is taken from book actually, but printing mistake is there. Small b molecules of, from, for small b moles of molecule B gives you what? Product. So how you can write the rate? Rate is equal to, you know, k. K, this is your what? Rate constant. This is what your rate constant. Okay, so concentration of A. Okay, or you can say it's an active mass of A raised to A, active mass of B raised to B. Okay, see, A and B are the, you know, A and B are the reactant. Okay, or you can say these are the active masses. These are the active these are the reactant. These are the reactant, but these are the active masses. Yes. So here in the square bracket A and square bracket B are the active masses of what? A and B. These are the reactant. A and B, they don't have reactant. So K is a rate constant. K is a rate constant. So from above equation, we can write K is equal to, that is rate constant is equal to rate upon A raised to A, B raised to B. Okay, so rate constant is defined as the rate of reaction at unit concentration of reactant. Unit concentration of what is rate constant? This is also called as specific reaction rate, is defined as the rate of a reaction at unit concentration. Kiska reactant ka jab unit concentration hota hai, hai na? So wo rate of reaction jo hai, that is called as a rate constant. Rate constant. Now see, the unit of rate constant is obtained by equation this one. Okay, see now. unit of rate constant. So unit of rate of reaction upon unit of concentration of reactant. तो इसका यूनिट यहाँ पे लिखना है और इसके यूनिट जो है यू डू टू भी इसके यूनिट्स यहाँ पे लिखना है. सो यूनिट ऑफ रेट कांस्टेंट इज यूनिट ऑफ रेट ऑफ रिएक्शन अपॉन यूनिट ऑफ कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ रिएक्टेंट. मींस सी दैट इन डिटेल. रेट कांस्टेंट इज इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ रिएक्टेंट. रेट कांस्टेंट जो है व्हाट रेट कांस्टेंट इज अ के इट्स इंडिपेंडेंट ऑन द कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ रिएक्टेंट. Okay, now the study of kinetic of chemical reaction involves determination of rate constant under given set of experimental condition. जो condition में हम कोई experiment करते हैं, वो condition में हम क्या करते हैं कि reaction का rate find out करते हैं, उसका reaction का हम kinetic study करते हैं, बराबर ना? अगर conditions change हो जाएंगे, temperature change हो जाएगा, pressure change हो जाएगा, तो definitely the kinetics is going to change. Now, see, two methods are there by which we can find out the rate of reaction. One is a chemical method, other is a physical method. ये chemical method में क्या करता है? Small volume of reactant निकालते हैं और वो उसका titration करते हैं किसी दूसरे reactant के साथ. Okay? और वहाँ पे indicator डाल के study करते हैं कि कितना वहां पे कंसंट्रेशन है ना. दैट इज डिटरमाइंड बाय द वॉल्यूमेट्रिक मेथड. डिटरमाइंड बाय द वॉल्यूमेट्रिक मेथड दैट यू आर गोइंग टू कैरी आउट दिस इन द केमिस्ट्री लैबोरेटरी. इट्स अ वेरी सिंपल. ओके, सो बाय टाइट्रेशन ओनली यू विल कम टू नो दैट हाउ मच ऑफ द रिएक्टेंट इज लेफ्ट इन द फ्लास्क. ओके, अगर हम यहाँ से 10 ml निकालते हैं, 1 ml निकालते हैं और रिएक्शन में टाइट्रेशन में यूज करते हैं और हमारे फ्लास्क में अगर 100 ml है तो इसका जो रीडिंग आएगा है ना, इसका जो रीडिंग आएगा एक का टाइट्रेशन का जो रीडिंग आएगा उसको हम क्या करेंगे, इसका फाइंड आउट करने के लिए इसको 100 से मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे. तो वो जो रीडिंग मिलेगा किस क्वांटिटी के लिए मिलेगा, इस क्वांटिटी के लिए मिलेगा. तो फिजिकल मेथड्स इसमें क्या करते हैं, स्मॉल अमाउंट ऑफ रिएक्टेंट दे टेक आउट एंड स्टडी इट विद द हेल्प ऑफ पोलैरिमीटर. Okay, or any other instrument. You can study the refractive index too. Okay, so that is also possible. So where we are using this physical method in inversion of cane sugar. Okay, then rate of saponification of ethyl acetate can be measured. Okay, over there we are going to use conductometer. Here we are using polarimeter to find out the inversion of cane sugar and to find out the saponification of ethyl acetate we are using conductometer. Okay, in which we are measuring the conductance. Okay, and in above method acid catalyzed hydrolysis of methyl acetate is studied with the help of above method. Okay, or reaction between the hydrogen peroxide and the hydrogen iodide can also be studied with the help of polymetric method. See order of reaction. What is order of reaction? See, the sum of exponent to which concentration term in the rate equation must be raised to obtain the observed dependence of rate on the concentration of reactant. This sentence is somehow confusing. Listen whatever I am saying here now. Very easy. See, A moles of A, B moles of B, and C moles of C reacts to form a product. So rate is given by rate constant into this is what, see here you have studied what is this active masses. Okay, active masses. So A raised to A, B raised to B, C raised to C. So sum of small a, small b and small c is called as order of reaction. If n is equal to 0, you may say as a zero order reaction. If n is equal to 1, call as a first order reaction. If n is equal to 2, call as a second order reaction, right? So reaction with the order greater than 3 are very rarely observed. Okay, so this much of the point are enough, are the more than sufficient to study the maximum reactions which are taking place around us. Okay, or we are carrying out in the chemical laboratory. Okay, so molecularity of reaction. the number of molecules taking part in a step leading to reaction. This step you called is as a RDS, rate determining step. Rate determining step. Okay, और ये कौन सा होता है रेट डिटरमाइनिंग स्टेप? आपने देखा होगा कि ट्रांजिशन स्टेट जब बनता है यहाँ पे एक्टिव मॉलिक्यूल रहता है उसका कैटायन और एनायन. सो दैट यू हैव स्टडीड बट लेट इट बी, डोंट गेट कंफ्यूज. इट इज ऑलवेज इंटीजर एंड नॉट डिपेंड ऑन द एक्सपेरिमेंटल कंडीशन. नॉट डिपेंड ऑन एक्सपेरिमेंटल कंडीशन. ओके, इट इज ऑलवेज ए इंटीजर. सो फॉर अ जनरल रिएक्शन गिवन अबो वी कैन से molecularity, the given below, instead of above, given below, you can say molecularity as a 3 for this reaction. See, two molecules of NO, one molecule of O2 gives you two molecules of NO2. So how molecularity is calculated? 2 plus 1. Here, in this case, 1 plus 1, that will become 2. Okay, see here, 1 plus 1, that will become 2. Okay, in this way you can find out the molecularity. Okay, and to find out the order, we need to make the sum of small a, b, and c. Then a concentration term raised. Now we'll see first order reaction. Okay, don't get bothered about the whatever theory is given over here. That appears to be somehow, you know. कि फार काही असं हे लिहिलेलं आहे तिथे असं वाटतं. यू जस्ट लिसन टू मी नाउ व्हॉट वी आर गोइंग टू डू. हा रिएक्टंट ए आहे त्याचं कन्वर्जन प्रॉडक्ट मध्ये होतं आहे, एवढं फक्त तुम्ही या ठिकाणी लक्षात घ्या. आता एचं कन्वर्जन कशात होत आहे? दॅट इज गेटिंग कन्वर्टेड टू द प्रॉडक्ट. की इनिशियल कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन ऑफ ए इज अ स्मॉल ए, प्रॉडक्ट ऍट द इनिशियली इज अ झिरो, दॅट इज झिरो वेन टाइम इज झिरो म्हणजे इनिशियल, बरोबर. आफ्टर टाइम टी, काही वेळानंतर, आफ्टर टाइम टी, एक्स कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन ऑफ दिस प्रॉडक्ट इज फॉर्म. कोणाचं कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन एक्स आहे, प्रॉडक्टचं बनलेलं आहे. मग हा कितीने लेस झालेला असेल, हा ए जो आहे तो कितीने लेस झालेला असेल, एक्सने लेस झालेला आहे, कारण त्याच्यातून एक्स कमी झाला किंवा आफ्टर टाइम टी. देअरफॉर आय एम रायटिंग हियर ए एज अ ए मायनस एक्स, कारण एवढं अमाऊंट पीचं बनलेलं आहे. ते कशापासून? याच्यापासून बनले. हे नाही, हे पाच असते आणि हा शून्य असता, आणि हा जेव्हा एक बनेल कोण पी, तेव्हा मी हा असा लिहू शकतो की नाही? फाईव्ह मायनस वन, है ना. इन्स्टेड ऑफ रायटिंग फोर आय एम रायटिंग एज अ फाईव्ह मायनस वन. नाव डिसन हियर, एज यू नो द रेट इक्वेशन. रेट कॅन बी डिफाइंड बाय टू वे, है ना, बाय कन्सिडरिंग द कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन ऑफ रिएक्टंट ऑर कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन ऑफ प्रॉडक्ट. से टाइम से see here, after time t, a minus x is the concentration of reactant. Okay, this is a mole per decimeter cube concentration, mole per decimeter cube. So at the time t, this is at the time t, this is already explained over here. Now see here, by considering the product dx upon dt is equal to k into a minus x, k into a minus x, we are focusing here the reactant concentration. And the reactant concentration, you know this equation now. See, kuthe ahe he ithe dilela aahe baga, reactant cha ya tikani tumhi kay ghetat, hai na, rate is equal to k into, samjha fakta a asta ithe reactant, tumhi kay lihla asta a raised to a. In the same way here, dx upon dt is equal to k into a minus x. So where k is what? Rate constant. Okay, so equation 7, this equation is a differential equation for first order reaction. On the rearranging above equation, we get dx upon, shift this a minus x to here and dt to here. So dx upon a minus x is equal to k into dt, k into dt. बरोबर ना. हा इकडे येताना काय होईल? हा डिनॉमिनेटरला जाईल, आणि हा dt इकडे जाताना काय होईल? न्यूमरेटरला येईल इथे, बरोबर ना. सी नाउ दिस इज व्हॉट द इक्वेशन. नाउ इंटिग्रेट दिस इक्वेशन. ओके, the start, at the start of the reaction, time is zero and amount of x was zero. You know, time at the start t was zero and product was zero. Bravo, that is x was zero here at the initial stage. Tithe fakta a hota. And after time t, kay zalela ahe? When t is equal to t, x is equal to x. X is equal to x. And a is equal to a minus x. See now. Here. At a time t is equal to t, x is equal to x. So integrating above equation, see integrating above equation where x is equal to 0 and here x is equal to x. That's dx upon a minus x. Ds upon a minus dx upon a minus x. And integrating this equation where x goes from 0 here to x is equal to x. Now k is equal to, again here t equal to 0 to t equal to t. Integrating this side. Integrating both sides, what we will get now? See, integration of dx upon a minus x is equal to minus ln of x. Barabar. Putting x is equal to x, putting initial x is equal to x, that is minus ln of a minus x minus of minus ln of a minus 0. Here it is 0. Right? So that is equal to k into t equal to 0. T equal to, so you can write here t minus 0, not equal to, sorry, t minus 0. Now, here by putting first t and then t equal to 0. So t minus 0. So that is equal to, how you can write here, minus minus become plus. So ln of a upon a minus x. This minus term will goes to, see now, a minus x goes to the denominator, or that is equal to k t. This is k t. So hence k is equal to shift this t. If the numerator la hai, tikade kay hoil denominator la. Therefore, 1 upon t into ln of a upon x. Ln of a upon x. This is actual equation now. And converting this to the log base to the base 10, log to the base 10. K is equal to 2.303. And jeva tumhi base 10 ghetat, log to the base 10 ghetat, tevha ithe 2.303. Ithe multiply karava lagel tumhala upon t into log to the base 10 a upon a minus x. See, these are the two equations which are very important for us now. Which one? Here it is. These two equations. Okay. This is very simple. You can solve it. Okay. Already it is there in the 12th standard. But again, we studied how it happens. Right? So, a is a conversion. Initially, a has a concentration small a, and the product's concentration zero is what time? Zero. But your time t equal to t is a concentration a minus x. The current product x amount. Now, in the same way, if you consider c zero as the initial concentration, and Ct is a concentration after time t, putting this concentration in above equation, this is the initial concentration, this is the concentration after time t. See here. Here, this is the initial concentration A, sorry, here it is. And this is the concentration after time t. So, here, C0 is the initial concentration, Ct is the concentration after time t. So, you can write k equal to 1 upon t into log to the base e c0 upon ct. Okay. Now log to the base 10 is converted to the log to the base e. That's why that 2.303 is get cancelled. Now this you can write as, you can write here ct is equal to c0 into a raised to minus kt. But he kasa lihtar baga. कसे अरेंज कराल तुम्ही kt equal to log to the base e into c0 upon ct. Right? Now, see. Therefore, can I write like this? e raised to kt is equal to c0 upon ct. Now, therefore, see now, CT is, that you can arrange as e raised to minus KT, e raised to minus KT, okay. Some of the student knows it very well, but for other student, equal to CT upon C0, right? What I did here, this is numerator goes to denominator, and denominator goes to numerator. Therefore, it's a symbol, it's a sign changes. It becomes minus over here. Here it was a plus. Therefore, you can write CT is equal to C0 e raised to minus KT. Right? See, here it is. This is for your information. Now, see, if A minus X1 is the amount of reactant at time T1, this A minus X2 is the amount of reactant at time T2, then we can write T1 is equal to, by focusing this equation, okay, or from this equation, which one? Here, from this equation, okay, or you can say from this equation, and I shift T to this side, K to this side, है ना? इतना numerator ला, denominator ला ही इतने जाता ना numerator लगाए, हाँ K इतने इतना denominator लगाए, see now, T1 is equal to 2.303 upon K into log of A upon A minus X1, for T2 again same, only here is X2, है ना 2.302, the 303 upon K into log of A upon A minus X2. So take a difference of these two terms, T2 minus T1 is equal to, by solving this, you know, what you will get, T2 minus T1 is equal to 2.303 upon K into log of A minus X1 upon A minus X2. Okay, therefore, shift K to this side, K is equal to 2.303 upon T2 minus T1 into log of A minus X1 upon A minus X2. Okay, you can write it there. Now we'll see the kinetic characteristics of first order reaction. What are the kinetic characteristics of first order reaction? So what characteristics are there? First, unit of first order rate equation, rate constant. Then half-life time for the first order reaction. And third is a graphical representation. Third is a graphical representation. Okay, now see. Here it is, unit of first order rate constant. This is the equation from which we are going to study the characteristics. See now, unit, how we can find out the unit? These two terms, this is a concentration term, this is a concentration term. So both the term get, the unit of both term get cancelled. Now, see, what is left? K is equal to 2.303 upon T. Actually, these are the numbers. जो तुम्ही हे करता ना, ते वहाँ का अश्नारे number अश्नारे त्या ठिकाणी, है ना? So K is equal to 2.3 upon T. So hence, unit of K will be the per time. है ना? K is equal to per time, or you can say as a per second. Per second, and you can find out in per minute. You can find out in per hour, you know, per day, per year. You can any way you can call it. Now half lifetime of first order reaction. Now what we have to do? Again same. Your reactant A is getting converted to the product P. So initial concentration A is of P is zero same, and time T zero same. After time T one half. Kiti vela nantar T one half. याचं कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन किती होईल? हाफ होईल. याचा हाफ झालं म्हणजे याचा पण किती बनलेला आहे? त्याच्यापासून हाफच बनलेला आहे हा, म्हणून हा हाफ झाला. गेटिंग माय पॉइंट? हा अर्धा झाला म्हणजे त्या अर्ध्याचं कन्वर्जन कशात झालेलं आहे? प्रॉडक्ट मध्ये झालेलं आहे. ए बाय टू, है ना? ना पुटिंग दिस इन अबो इक्वेशन काय होईल? के इज इक्वल टू 2.303 अपॉन टी इंटू लॉग ऑफ स्मॉल ए अपॉन ए माइनस एक्स. So at 50% conversion, x is equal to a by x. Therefore, k is equal to 2.303 upon t one half into log of a upon a by 2. What the value we are inserting? We are inserting here the concentration of reactant after टाइम टी वन हाफ किती टाइम झाल्यानंतर टी वन हाफ टी वन हाफ ला याचं कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन किती किती हे किती कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन असेल दॅट वी नो ए बाय टू ए बाय टू असणार आहे बरोबर ना इनिशियल हे इनिशियलच असणार आहे पण काही टाइम अर्ध्या टी वन हाफ ला याचं कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन किती हे महत्वाचं आहे ना वॉट यू विल डू सी ए गेट कॅन्सल अँड दिस गोज टू द न्युमरेटर टू गिव्ह गोज टू द न्युमरेटर सो लॉग ऑफ टू इज अ पॉइंट 303 0.3010 हा लक्षातच ठेवा आता बऱ्याचशा ठिकाणी तुम्हाला गरज पडेल त्याच्यानंतर तुम्हाला मास्टर डिग्रीला जरी गेलात तुम्ही पीएचडीला जरी गेलात ह्या विषयामध्ये पीएचडी केली तरी ती व्हॅल्यू वारंवार तुम्हाला तिथे बघायला मिळेल ना के इज इक्वल टू 2.303 अपॉन टी वन हाफ इंटू लॉग ऑफ ए बाय ए अपॉन टू किंवा ए वन हाफ ना से 2.303 T1 upon T1 half is equal to 0.3010. Okay, now here 0 point make a multiplication 0.693 upon T1 half that is equal to T1 half equal to 0.693 upon K. This is what the half lifetime for first order reaction. Half lifetime for the first order reaction. Okay, now graphical representation. त्या ठिकाणी दोन पद्धतीने आपण त्या ठिकाणी ग्राफिकल रिप्रेझेंटेशन करू शकतो बघा पहिली जी केस आहे अगेन वी हॅव टू कन्सिडर द सेम इक्वेशन ओके देअरफॉर के इंटू टी अपॉन 2.303 न्यूमरेटर बघा हे इक्वेशन वरती रिअरेंज केलं काय झालं के टी अपॉन 2.303 ही टर्म त्या ठिकाणी राईट साईडला राहिलेली आहे ओके सी दिस टर्म या साईडला आहे देअरफॉर See what happened? Log of a upon a minus x is equal to kt upon ते तुम्ही असे लिहू शकता हे इकडे आणि हे इकडे ओके नाव अबव इक्वेशन इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ स्ट्रेट लाईन वाय इज इक्वल टू एम एक्स प्लस सी वाय इज इक्वल टू एम एक्स प्लस सी इथे सी आहे का काही कॉन्स्टंट आहे का नाही इथे काय सी इज इक्वल टू काय आहे झिरो आहे बरोबर ना So, this is what k upon 2.303 is your m. This is what your m. Barabar. And this is what your x. T is your x. Where it is? Yeah, here it is. Now what is y? Y-axis for kai geta hai tumi? Log of k upon a minus x. See here. On y-axis, you are taking log of a upon a minus x. On x-axis you are taking time. This is your time. See, this is a time as x on x-axis. This you are taking on y-axis. Okay. Now, what is the slope? What is the slope? What is left here? K upon 2.303. K upon 2.303 is a slope. Is a slow right here k upon 2.303 is a slow here that is they have not written here now again you can rearrange above equation as kt is equal to you know his puna rearrange kariya he equation hai na aplyakade kay karuya log of a minus log of a minus x log of a minus log of a minus x is equal to काय लिहाल तुम्ही हा लॉग ऑफ ए मायनस एक्स इकडेच राहू देत हा इकडे शिफ्ट करा ओके व्हॉट विल हॅपन किंवा हा इकडे शिफ्ट करा आयदर वे यू कॅन डू इट बाय रिअरेंजिंग अबव इक्वेशन सी व्हॉट वी विल गेट लॉग ऑफ ए मायनस एक्स इज इक्वल टू मायनस के टी अपॉन 2.303 प्लस लॉग ऑफ ए प्लस लॉग ऑफ ए right so on again you compare this with the equation of straight line what is the y what is there on y axis log of a minus x what is the slope it's a minus k upon 2.303 slope is a minus c it is a minus slope okay this is a positive slope this is a negative slope k upon minus k upon 2.303 is what? Your M. What is X? Is a T. What is X? Is a T, right? And what is a C? It's a A. It's a log of A. See here, intercept. This is an intercept, log of A. Slope is a negative, that is K upon 2.3 north, right? Here, slope is a positive. Slope is a positive. Therefore, slope can be found, that K can be found out by slope into 2.3 north. Slope into 2.3 north. Here is again, K can be found out by 2 into the K into 2.3 north. Okay, now. What are the example for first order reaction? You know, first order reaction, see, thermal decomposition madhe tumhala distil, tyanantar isomerization reaction ahe te ani kahi reaction ahe. These are the examples. Nitrogen pentoxide converted to the N2O3 plus O2 molecule is given out. PCl5 when heated, that converts to the PCl3 and Cl2. P2O5 phosphorus pentoxide converted to P2O3 and O2. काय इथे थर्मल आहे सगळ्यांना काय द्यायची इथे हीट द्यायची आहे काय द्यायची हीट द्यायची आहे आइसोमरायझेशन मध्ये बघा काय होतंय दिस इज एक्चुअली नॉट द प्रॉपर पे असं होतं दाखवायला पाहिजे व्यवस्थित सीएल या ठिकाणी दुसरीकडे दाखवायला पाहिजे होता बट लेट इट बी आणि हा याला कनेक्ट करायचं होतं let it be, no problem. Consider this, that is a N-chloroacetaniline. N-chloroacetaniline. Tumhala ti varcha dakhavto kasa ahe. Nitrogen la chloro attach ahe. Ani ithe kay tumchi benzene ring is there. Okay. Always write this in this way. This is a wrong representation which is shown in the book. Okay, don't show this as a circle. Okay, nowadays, not nowadays, bharpur divas varsha zale tyala ki he presentation tya thikani stop kelela ahe. Aye apna jo hai IUPAC apna jo chemistry ka ye hai international board hai unhone stop kiya hai. Now next point, radioactive decay obeys first order kinetics. See, now radium undergoes alpha decay to give radon gas. And radium pasun ka vichay tumhala radon gas. Now you know that lambda is equal to 2.303 upon T into log of N0 upon NT. Here is a number of radioactive atom at the start of the decay. These are after number of the radioactive atom at the time T. Okay, now the above equation can be represented as by taking log to the base e. Here log to the base 10 on it. Remember? Log to the base e, N0 upon ENT. So we are rearranging this equation. And upon agudharaj bagitlela ahe, kasa rearrange karayacha ahe. Ikade ha yala numerator la jai. Lambda t is equal to log of N0 upon ENT. Therefore, N0 upon ENT is equal to e raised to lambda t. Therefore, nt numerator la nila ahe ani ha denominator la nila ahe mhanun yacha symbol ka hoil negative hoil ithe barobar. Therefore, nt is equal to n0 e raised to minus lambda t. Okay, and t 1/2 is equal to, this is the equation what we have seen here. Okay, and t 1/2 is equal to 0.693 upon lambda upon lambda. So we'll see one or two example for this. Calculate the time required for completion of kiti 25% reaction ani 75% reaction complete honyasathi first order reaction je ahe tila kiti vel lagel jeva tumhala rate constant dilela ahe that's value kiti 2.2 into 10 raised to minus 3 per second ha tyachi value ithe enter kara hai na ata this is equation. What is given? K is given. Now what they are saying? 25% reaction complete hote. 25% reaction complete hote ani 75% reaction complete hote. Jo 25% reaction complete hoil tewa x mhanje kon jo product asnar hai hai na product kiti banlela asnar hai. X is a concentration of product after time t. ती आता इथे किती म्हणतोय 25%, मग त्याचे पर्सेंट 25% ऑफ ए है ना, तुम्ही बघितलं बघा इथे तुम्हाला पुन्हा दाखवतो मी, ए इज गेटिंग कन्वर्टेड टू द प्रोडक्ट पी, सो इनिशियल कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन इज ए, ए इज झिरो है ना, जेव्हा 25% कन्वर्जन झालं तेव्हा हा किती टक्के बनलेला आहे, एक्स किती बनलेला आहे तो 25% बनलेला आहे, तर हा किती राहील, रिएक्टंट किती राहील, 75% राहील, बरोबर ना, हा 75% राहील, कोणतं इनिशियल कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन, टाइम टी, आफ्टर टाइम टी इट विल बी 75% अँड दिस इज 25%, सो याचं कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन आफ्टर टाइम किती किती असणार आहे, 25% ऑफ इनिशियल कॉन्सन्ट्रेशन, सो 25/100 इंटू ए दॅट इज इक्वल टू 0.25 वॉट एक्स है ना. नाउ वी हैव द इक्वेशन, टेक एक्स एज ए 0.25, सेम इज द कैलक्युलेशन फॉर 75%, इथे 0.25 ए आला तसंच इथे 75% घेतला तर 75/100 इंटू ए होईल है ना, इथे 75/100 इंटू ए, देअरफॉर इट विल बिकम 0.75 इंटू ए होईल, कशासाठी, सेकंड केस मध्ये, हे बघा इथे आहे एक्स इज अ 0.75 इंटू ए राईट, putting this value now 25% of completion of reaction t 1/4 t 1/4 2.303 upon k into log of a upon a minus 0.25 a, this is what the value of k, put here okay, and solving this, by solving this you will get t 1/4 you know 25% reaction complete hoyla kiti vel lagel 143.8 seconds. You calculate it, because most of the time there may be the printing mistake in the textbook. What we have observed while doing this calculation in the class, as I am giving you online, and I have taken all the matter from book only. Okay, so that you will feel it more familiar while reading the textbook. Okay, otherwise, you know, actually PPT banvai samandhi tithe any matter lihala paise. But for the your familiarity to get you more familiar with the textbook data, I have taken photocopies over here. Okay. See now, for the 75% means t 3/4. Just put here 0.75 a, and do the calculation. How much time is required? 693.3 seconds are required for the completion of 75% reaction. आणि 25% रिएक्शन व्हायला डेफिनेटली त्याच्यापेक्षा कमी वेळ लागणार आहे. किती वेळ लागतोय इथे तुम्ही काढलेला आहे ना, सी हियर 143.8 seconds, आणि इथे एवढा वेळ लागतो आहे, बरोबर. तर आपण किती पर्सेंट रिएक्शन कम्प्लीट व्हायला किती वेळ लागू शकतो हे आपण कॅल्क्युलेट करू शकतो. नाउ सेकंड एक्झाम्पल, फर्स्ट ऑर्डर रिएक्शन इज 40% कम्प्लीट आहे, बघा आता इथे कम्प्लीट झालेली सांगितली, किती वेळात, 100 सेकंद लागतात तिला. But calculate the time required for 90% reaction to complete. Na 40% reaction vayla 100 second, to 90% reaction complete vayla kiti vel. Ata ite cross multiplication naka karu, jase ki 40 requires 100, so 90 requires how much, that is wrong method, don't go for the cross multiplication. You find out first k, किती टक्के, 40% रिएक्शन कम्प्लीट व्हायची आहे, म्हणजे एक्स ची व्हॅल्यू किती आहे इथे 0.4 a, दाखवलंय तुम्हाला अगोदरच्या इक्वेशन मध्ये एक्स ची व्हॅल्यू कशी काढायची, या इथे दाखवलेलं आहे तुम्हाला एक्स ची व्हॅल्यू कशी काढायची, 0.4 a, जस्ट पुट द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ एक्स हियर इन दिस इक्वेशन, यू विल गेट दिस राईट, बघा ए मायनस एक्स इज इक्वल टू 0.6 a, तीच खाली डिनॉमिनेटरला घेतलेली व्हॅल्यू इथे, इथे ए मायनस एक्स असतो ना नेहमी, आणि इथे ए असतो, मग लॉग ऑफ ए ए गेट कॅन्सल 1/0.6, दॅट विल बिकम 1.66, सो लॉग ऑफ 1.66 इज सी नाउ हियर 2.303/100 इंटू लॉग ऑफ 1.66, व्हाट हॅपन्स, द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ के इज 5.106 इंटू 10^-3 सेकंड, it should be per second, and this is wrong actually, current time ha denominator la hai, हाँ केची वैल्यू पर सेकंड पाहिजे इथे, युनिट पर सेकंड पाहिजे. 90% कंप्लीट व्हायला किती लागेल तुम्हाला? ए ची व्हॅल्यू पुन्हा एक्स ची व्हॅल्यू माहिती 0.9 आहे, इथे के ची व्हॅल्यू माहिती आहे, है ना. मग काय केलाय त्यांनी, टी इकडे शिफ्ट केला ह्या इक्वेशन मध्ये, जनरल इक्वेशन मध्ये, आणि के इकडे घेतलेला आहे. सो जस्ट एंटर द व्हॅल्यू, पुट द व्हॅल्यू, के इथे टाकला, यू विल गेट द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ टी हियर, है ना. शिफ्ट दिस टू दिस साइड, के टू दिस साइड, सॉरी के फ्रॉम हियर इज शिफ्टेड टू हियर, एंड टी विच वॉज हियर दैट इज शिफ्टेड टू दिस साइड. Rearranging equation, you will get the T now. How much time is required for the completion of 90% reaction? 451 seconds. Getting my point? So this is very simple. Okay, upon that again, find out karu shakto. Okay. So for the first lecture, this is enough. In the first lecture of chemical kinetics topic, we have studied the first order reaction. Okay, in the next lecture we are going to start second order reaction. Okay, so thank you. Do one thing, listen the lecture again and again carefully. Once you listen this lecture once, twice, thrice, the concept will get very clear to you. Okay, now this is depends upon you. So thank you.